Hey folks, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to our Jurassic World Evolution 2 Mod Spotlight series. We've got seven pretty great mods to take a look at today. Really excited to dig into all of this, but a disclaimer. First of all, as per usual, mods can and possibly will break your game, especially when there's a big chunky update, which is probably still, maybe a month and a half away based on usual schedule. We'll have to wait and see. Either way, they can do a little bit of damage. If they do a little bit of damage, it's not my fault. It's not the mod maker's fault. And it most certainly is not Frontier's fault. As Modius is with us today.
Hello!
I've got a new mic. It's like a podcast-y sort of mic, so this is good. We can do a podcast. Crime. People love crime podcasts. As Modius, how do you feel about crime?
I love crime.
As Modius loves crime. There we go. Okay, so let's move on with our lives very quickly. So we've got two brand new species to kick things off. First of all, let's check out this Yutyrannus mod. Very cool. This is Yutyrannus by Master Dutar, early Cretaceous Chinese theropod, well-known dinosaur, of course, one of my absolute favourite. A Proceratosaurid living in these temperate rainforests where it would have had immense fluctuation in temperature, and of course we know it was feathered. But it looks really cool. I really like it. I think it suits the dinosaur quite well. I've seen some suggestions already from people that Yutyrannus, why would it have a tail fan, given the size of the dinosaur, but we know some other humongous feathered dinosaurs that would have had tail fans, so why not? If you're going to use it for display, it doesn't really matter how large you are, you still have to be sexy, and that's a lesson I live by myself, it doesn't matter how big you are. Right, you can take that however you want to take it, but it doesn't matter how big you are, you still have to be sexy. You have to put in the work, and Yutyrannus is definitely putting in the work. You can also see, we've got the featherage at the back, but the texture on the body itself. So this is like the thick coat, and then we've got this kind of mottled feathering along the body itself, kind of textured into the skin. Let's just check out another set of them. Have a look at these colours. See if we find one a little less Darth Maul-y. That's already better, I think. Yeah, they look pretty damn cool. I'd love to see this feathering blended in with the rest of the body a little bit better. It looks like it's wearing a really long hat to an extent, but I still think it looks fantastic. Absolutely adore the dinosaur, and the more Yutyrannus mods we have... Well, right, I thought putting the tower in the middle would look cool. And all it's doing is causing me pain. But, pretty sweet start to the day. So, our next new species, our only other new species, technically, is a Tethyshadros. And you're in the way, aren't you? So, as you may be able to tell from the exceptional quality of this mod, Tethyshadros is an LA Studios dinosaur, our next LA Studios dinosaur. It's our first Italian dinosaur I think we've ever talked about on the channel, because Italy, this Hadrosaur from Italy really has no dinosaurs at all. Italy's had like four dinosaurs in history, so that makes Tethy itself pretty remarkable. And Tethy is, as you can probably tell by looking at it, quite small for Hadrosaurid. It's a pygmy or a dwarf Hadrosaurid, and it likely went through insular dwarfism in that it lived on island chains, and as a smaller island kind of how do I explain this? As generations of dinosaurs are born onto a small island with a scarcity of resources, as those resources start to dwindle, it's the smaller dinosaurs that survive for longer because they require less food to survive, to live to long age. So eventually you get smaller and smaller. Over generations and generations and generations, you get smaller and smaller dinosaurs until you end up with these little tiny dwarfism dinosaurs. Anyways, it's LA Studios. It's remarkably well done. The skin patterning is absolutely beautiful. Nice, relatively standard sort of Hadrosaur model. But what I really like is the detailing on the beak more than anything. You see we've got these kind of ridges built into the top and bottom of the beak. It looks like it'd be really effective for tearing into vegetation, more than anything else. Or bread. Kind of looks like a bread knife. Either way, really, really cool little detail. Gives the dinosaur a lot of personality. This is the Tethyshadros 2022 skin, according to the species release, I think. So there is a bunch of other skins as well, but this seems to be the one that they wanted to highlight, so I thought I would do just that. Right, moving on with our lives. We've got a lot to do today, so I'm going to zim-zam-zom along, as they say in the clubs. Next three are all replacements and edits and stuff like that, so we're going to check out a Troodon mod next. So this is the Isle Evremer Troodon. So the some of you watching this will be a little confused. The Isle does not currently have a Troodon, but Dondi posted a picture of it online, and the mod maker Daviono, I do apologize, has kind of taken that and applied the color scheme and the modeling, etc., to the in-game Troodon. I've got to say, I mean, the Isle has some fantastic dinosaur games, dinosaur designs. It may not be the game for me anymore. But just because of the general style, but the dinosaur designs are pretty top. All right, calm down, buddy. This is why I have to pause. But the dinosaur designs are pretty exceptional at times. And this Troodon, I would say, is no exception. Really, really cool coloring, really cool patterning. Brought into the game really nicely by Daviono. And, you know, yeah, it's a replacement, but it kind of just feels like a whole new dinosaur in a way. I actually might prefer it to the default Troodon. I know that's maybe slightly blasphemous, but I love the colour scheme. That colour is really popping there, and that bright blue interior mouth as well, just like you would see on some particular, you know, that bright blue tongue as well, like you might see on some modern lizards, etc. Looks really evocative, really interesting to look at. Yeah, brilliant stuff. Cool. Right, two more replacements to go. Three more, actually. There's a cheeky little one you can't see quite yet. So this is a mod. I'm going to explain this briefly. This is a mod called Alien Dinosaurs, made by Golden Dragon. Now, they have done a huge number of species replacements, and basically they're taking existing dinosaurs and trying to make them look like they're from another planet, make them look a little bit more alien, archify them a little bit, basically. Now, some of them are fantastic looking, some of them, I'll admit, like, look fairly terrible, you know, it's a coin toss, but I had to look through all the images, and the one that really stood out to me, looks really cool potentially, is the Pyroraptor. So definitely go, you don't have to install all of them, you can pick and choose the ones you like best based on the pictures. I'm going to showcase the Pyroraptor today. Definitely go check out the others on the Nexus though. You'll see why I like it. Let's have a look. I've not seen it in game though, so we'll have to see. Right, I've got too many Yutyrannuses. It's causing a problem. I mean, look at it. Right, there's one in particular I want to grab. I think it's this one at the front. What an absolute beast. Can we just get it into a little bit? Yutyrannus, get out of the way. Tower, get out of the way. Okay, so there we go. That is our alien Pyroraptor. I think it's fantastic. So we can see some changes here on the skull shape. It's the feather work. The feather work is exceptional. This dramatic plumage, like you'll see in a lot of modern birds, at the back of the head looks really, really cool. It's kind of got this, you know, cliche Chinese emperor kind of feel, like you see in old books and stuff like that. It's definitely got that big headdress and sort of emperor kind of feel to it, including mainly because of this little beard here as well, which I think is very Chinese emperor. So we've got the little beard feathers, we've got the huge plumage at the back of the head, the feathers along the body have been kind of expanded outwards and flattened out there, the wings are large and glorious, and of course the tail fan itself is also huge. Some of the stuff in this mod I think looks pretty terrible. The Spinosaurus, for example, I think is awful. I'm so sorry. Like, I'm trying to compliment, and I'm insulting to compliment, I promise. Because then I compare it to this, which I think is genuinely phenomenal. I'm not sure I'd use it for something, but you could maybe make, like, an alien dinosaur park. I just think the quality of work on this Pyroraptor is genuinely pretty sweet. I mean, that is beautiful. I'm genuinely amazed by how much I love this Pyroraptor. Right, anyways, one more in this current list. Let's pop out a Mementosaurus. Forgive me if I speed this up, because Mementosaurus takes about half an hour to exit the hatchery. Especially when it's a big boy. It's kind of half the point. God. So this is Mementosaurus 1997, made by Master Dude. A shout out to Master Dude, by the way, because I don't remember Master Dude posting much for the first Jurassic World Evolution, and they've popped up in Evolution 2 and been, I mean, maybe they did, I don't want to, I'm not saying they didn't, but I'm just saying I've seen them a lot more for Evolution 2, and they're producing some of the best mod stuff out there, and consistently with new fantastic mods as well. But this is a pretty simple model change to the Mimetosaurus, which A, makes it a lot larger, as you can see. It's fairly gigantic now. It's a lot longer as well. And more importantly than anything, it really changes the neck shape. It's looking a little funky there, but just let me straighten it out. It changes the neck shape, because the Mimetosaurus in the game is quite straight and quite, you know, very excited Mimetosaurus. But in 1997, the Lost World Mimetosaurus, which we only see briefly during the Safari game trail kind of scene though, but it has this very evocative zoop kind of swoop to the neck, and that was missing in the evolution version of the dinosaur for some reason. It wasn't really the, it never felt like the 1997 Mimetosaurus, it just felt like a random Mimetosaurus. This feels a lot more like the one from 1997. You can imagine, you know, a motorbike driving through those legs right now, which I often imagine anyway, just for funsies. Yeah, really simple little model edit, but just makes the dinosaur better, in my opinion. Gives it more personality, makes it stand out more compared to the other sauropods in the game. Now, don't get me wrong, the 1997 Mimetosaurus is kind of a disaster in a lot of ways, but that's neither here nor there. It's a cool dose of nostalgia, and I love it. So shout out to Master Dude for that. Now, I do have one more species replacement to show you, kind of a joke one that we tend to leave to the end, but I'm going to show you something else in the meantime. Okay, while my final batch of dinosaurs, or non-dinosaurs, I should say, is hatching away, I'm going to show you this scenery item that I completely forgot to show you. This came out a while ago now, a month and a half ago, something like that. This is J.P. Inez. I don't really understand the title, if I'm totally honest. Jipenez. J.P.N.E.S. New Scenery 2 by Sir Zero John. It just adds a bunch of new scenery items to the game, part of your decorations tab that you can use to make your parks a little bit more exciting. So we've got this visitor center, quasi-visitor center kind of thing over here, this big chunk of amber there at the top, very big chunk of amber. And these really cool, really stylized, kind of slightly, you know, simple geometry brachiosauruses standing guard. Love those. Would love to see this, John, by the way. It's like an individual item. Just saying. I would definitely use that. Over here, we've got a speaker dino tracker kind of thing. These were in the park. If you play Jurassic Park S, which everybody should play Jurassic Park S, and do so before you watch my video on the game, you'll see these in that game as well. I can't remember what they are. They're like access thingamajiggies, tracking things, yada yada yada. We've got John's Toy Shop, which even has all these little toy shop interior details, which is really cool. Don't know what that is, but I love it. What's this? This is a log. That's a log. Ignore the log, it's not part of the mod. Over here we've got a, I think this is the command center. Yes, the command compound. Very cool. We've got a bin, which I've hidden in the shadows for some reason. But yeah, a little bin, you know, a bin decoration might not seem like a big deal, but if you're building a park, it's actually kind of necessary. Hint, hint. Over here, we've got a few different signs, just in different colours. These big old JP signs. Still the best logo this series has ever had, by the way. This big old JP like that. Love that. Deeply, deeply love that. We've got a park map. Just, again, a really cool thing to have in your general park lying around. You know, it just suits a park build. So we've got a lovely park map. Over here, we've got a tennis court. That's a full-on tennis court. So again, if you wanted to make your park more of a resort, more like Jurassic World, just kind of things we, I feel like we need this in Jurassic Park or Jurassic World Evolution 2, I should say, so much more than we have. Just things that make it feel less like a series of dinosaurs and more like a park resort, because that's what Jurassic World is and that's how it's posited. And finally over here, we've got the Safari Lodge. So that we have this lovely sign, this is individual, so this Safari Lodge sign, and then the Safari Lodge itself with, again, these brachiosauruses at the entrance, and there's a reception, and there's your big old hotel Safari Lodge kind of thing. So a bunch of different decorations. I think there's 12 or something in total. Really good stuff, really nice addition. Just before we get to the Lystrosaurus that you just saw pop up, there is one more really cool decoration mod that came out this week. I'm planning to use that as part of my sandbox build, so I'm not showing it to you in today's video, but we will be covering it this week, in case people were wondering why I haven't covered what seems like a fairly obvious thing to cover. So anyways, moving on, our last mod of the day is a Lystrosaurus replacement. I say replacement. I love it so much. Man, that pyroraptor is awesome. Right, this is this is Fat Lystrosaurus, basically. This is Fat Lystrosaurus by Yaz, and often I'll say it does what it says on the tin, but yeah, it does what it says on the tin. It chunkifies the Lystrosaurus a little bit. It's kind of adorable. Let me just replace the... Let's get some sand on the ground so we can see it a little bit better. Right, where's that one I was looking? There you are. Hello, buddy. It just adds a massive pot belly and thickens a lot of the Listro up. But now, you know, it doesn't look too dissimilar to the default one. It just makes it... It's kind of like when you get a sausage casing and you stuff it just a little bit too full, you know? However sexual you want to make that metaphor is completely up to you, but that's kind of what the Listrosaurus looks like. It's very cute. I love a little jokey meme mod. There was a couple of us this week, but this is the one I chose to look at. And I think it reminds me of that meme with the, you know, the cat that's jumping and it's kind of tucked its legs in, so it kind of looks like the cat is hovering and floating towards the camera. This is that's kind of what the Listro is doing, essentially. What an absolute beast. So shout out to Yaz for that one. And shout out to everyone else today. That's Yaz, Sir Zero, John, Master Dude Twice, Golden Dragon, Daviono, and of course LA Studios. Some fantastic, fantastic mods. We will have another mod, as I say, to take a look at later on in this week. So stick around for that. But that's going to be part of our Malta sandbox build thingamajiggy. So until then, thank you so much for joining me. Check out all these mods at the link in the description down below. Throw me a like if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you lovely folks tomorrow or the day after, depends how long it takes, for something a little bit different. Cheers. Thank you for joining me. There we go. I remembered what I've said 5,000 times before. Thank you for joining me. Cheers, much love as always. Bye bye.